let's talk to that witness again, see if he remembers anything else. Did you find other suspects?
We're in the middle of conversation, Michael.
It's okay. Good idea. No, we do not have another suspect right now, Michael.
No, of course not, because you had the guy and you let him go. D'Onofrio had a history of violence and you let him walk.
Of yelling insults at strippers, that's it.
Look, we do have rules to follow, Michael, and we literally have nothing to tie this guy into the attacks.
You know, maybe somebody more motivated might be able to nail him. Somebody who's not worried about following those rules.
Let's go talk over here.
Dante, I don't want to be handled, okay? I just want answers.
Maybe you should. You're looking like you're out of control.
No, yeah, I get like that when cops sit on their hands.
We're doing everything we can.
Well, obviously it's not good enough. But he's gonna target another dancer.
You gotta stop, okay? You're acting like you're obsessed here. You look like hell.
Yeah, I've been hearing that.
Why are you getting any sleep?
I keep thinking about those girls.
Abby wasn't one of those girls. She was an accident. You don't need to avenge her.
Okay, so what do you want me to do instead? Just sit at my apartment? Do you have any idea how hard it is to be there without her? I sit there just waiting for her to walk through that door any second.
Okay, look, why don't you come by my place? You stay as long as you want. Me and Lulu and you will watch a movie, have some dinner. I promise I won't let her cook.
No. I have plans.
I don't care what he says. He does not get security clearance. He doesn't get an ID. He doesn't even get a key to my private bathroom. And the next time you do anything without my direct approval, you and your fancy MBA will be cleaning my private bathroom.
Hello? Hi. Have you been getting any of my calls? I've been worried about you.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Sorry. As you can see, I'm just fine.
Well, sit down. Let's talk. Have a glass of wine.
Well, actually, I can't. I was called away unexpectedly. I only just got back, and I have an awful lot to catch up on.
Well, everyone has time for a glass of wine, especially Tracy Quartermain. Or is it Tracy Zakarin?
Hey, Mike, I promise you, we will catch this guy.
Yeah, I'm sure that makes the girls feel so much better.
Do you think Abby would want you doing this, ruining your life?
You didn't even know her.
I know she'd want you to take care of yourself. Let us catch this guy.
No, we actually already caught the bastard, but we just throw him back.
What are you doing?
Well, everybody knows D'Onofrio's back on the street. He's probably scoping out his next victim right now.
Hey, can we not do this right now?
D'Onofrio had an alibi for two of the attacks, and we have his phone record.
Well, that's fantastic. Good, solid police work, Padilla. Great. You know, anybody could have called that AA sponsor. Not to mention, who the hell still uses a phone booth?
Look, Ronnie, we have been over all of this already.
We can only go by the evidence that we have.
Why do I get the feeling you're on D'Onofrio's side? It's like you guys are more concerned about his rights than getting a piece of garbage off the street.
That's enough. Just stop.
Michael, we are going to solve this case.
Can you just hang on 1 minute? Just hang on 1 minute. He's in a bad place right now. Can we watch what we say?
Dude, maybe he shouldn't be hanging around the squad room then, okay?
Mike, where the hell did he go?
He said he had plans.
You're worried your not-so-little brother's gonna go vigilante?
Well, you know what? It doesn't help when you come in here spouting off about how we let go of the one guy you think did it.
I'm just calling him as I see him.
Well, why don't you watch your mouth? Okay, next time, try not to put down a fellow officer in front of a civilian.
This is about Padilla? Oh, that's so sweet. That must feel so good.
Why don't
Detective Charming over here to the rescue.
Why don't you stop treating her like the hired help, okay? Stop putting down everything
you
she
didn't
does.
Even want Padilla as a partner.
Okay, but she's proven herself, okay? She's worked hard, so why don't you lay off?
You know, it is so sweet the way you defend her honor. Oh, hey, Olivia.
Mm-hmm.
You must be so proud you raised such a good boy, huh? Who defends his women's honor, whether it's his wife or his mother or even his partner.
What are you talking about?
Officer Padilla, may I, request the honor of your company?
Just don't talk to me like that.
That woman was the same perfume as Lulu.
Yeah, I know. I realized that the first time I met her.
So you did realize it?
I'm kind of busy here, Ma.
I don't care. I want to talk about the fight you had with Lulu.
What do you thought? I didn't even have a fight with Lulu.
That's funny. She said the exact same thing.
Okay, so what are you talking about?
Well, she's planted over at the hotel right now enjoying a great big old glass of wine.
What are you getting at?
Just that she seemed awfully comfortable with a mid-morning drink.
Great. She's an adult. She can vote, drive, and have a drink with the lunch if she wants to.
Okay, I'm just saying.
No. That's the thing about you. You never just say anything.
Here's how I think. If it was you, I would want to know.
Okay, would you want to know? Lulu's wondering what to do with her life. So if she went to the Metro Court for lunch to treat herself, then good for her.
Don't blow this off, honey. Pay attention to your wife.
Oh, you mean the way Steve is treating you?
Okay, where'd that come from?
I'm just trying to give you a gentle reminder that maybe you should stick to your life and stay out of mine. Remember Mrs. Divinchin?
Okay. All right, I get it. This is me backing off.
You know, I'm kind of curious, though. Now, did you ever talk to Steve about how you felt about him hiring his girlfriend?
Ex-girlfriend.
What, did you tell him you wanted to take
okay,
things more seriously?
I get it. All right, you mind your own business. I'll mind my business. All right? Just don't say I didn't warn you about either one of your partners.
So was it a nice wedding, at least?
Actually, it was a freak show, and you can tell your friend the wedding planner that I said so.
Oh, you're Maxie's mystery VIP client.
Not me, Anthony. I was just the hostage.
He kidnapped you?
It's a long story. How was that wine?
It's fabulous.
Is it fabulous? Mm. Could I have a glass of that fabulous wine?
So, why did you marry Anthony if you can't stand him? What does he have on you?
Who said he has anything on
me? Well, why would you marry someone else when you're still in love with my dad?
Speaking of your dad, he showed up.
He did.
He did. We were on a boat, and just as Game Runner, the minister.
Game Runner, the minister.
Yeah, don't ask. Just as he said, speak now or forever hold your peace. Voila, there was your dad.
Did you try to stop the wedding?
Actually not. He rushed us right along to the I do's.
Huh. Well, that doesn't explain why you married Anthony when you could have had him arrested for kidnapping.
You already figured it out.
He's blackmailing you.
I was just trying to stall.
Isn't getting married a little extreme?
Beat the alternative.
Hey! What are you doing here? I thought you were working all day.
Yeah, I wanted to come and say hello to my lovely wife. And hey, Tracy,
we have
been very worried about you.
In common with Tracy, we're all newlyweds.
Oh, so you decided to marry Anthony after all.
No comment. Maybe you should actually talk to him about your situation. He could
maybe help. We could just enjoy our wine.
So guess who stopped by the station since she ran into you over here?
Your mother?
Yeah, her own relationship is neutral, so she has to get in the middle of mind.
Yeah, she didn't like that I was having a glass of wine with lunch.
I'm sorry if she put you on the spot.
No, it's fine. Yeah, I just don't want you to worry. It's just a glass of wine.
I'm not worried. You have to explain anything to me. Look, have you seen Michael around?
No, why?
I don't know. He's pretty volatile, and I don't want him getting himself into a dangerous situation.
Oh, well, I mean, go find him. I'll talk to you later.
Okay.
I see you.
Congratulations again.
Why are we discussing your intake of wine?
What the hell happened?
It's Chuck D'Onofrio.
He's a suspect in the stripper attacks. He's been shot in the chest, Michael. He's dead.